In this episode, we're going to show you how to connect your data cable and your power cables.
You're watching IT Pro TV.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in to more of our hands-on PC build. Yes, today's show is all about connections. In fact, we're going to go ahead and get our power connections connected. We're going to get our data connection on our solid-state drive and then the various connections in the case. So here on the bench, we've kind of laid this on the side. We've taken the sidewall of the case, both sides off, the left and the right side of our case off. Both of those panels are just off to the side. And what we're going to do is essentially we're going to take the power connections. We're going to go ahead and undo the connections from the case here, and we're going to go ahead and route them. And where we're going to route them, you're going to see there's some routing spots here that we can actually do that. So what do you say, let's go ahead and get started, and I'm going to undo our power connections here, and we're going to go ahead and start with the routing of our cables. Now, first things first, what I'm going to do is I'd like to go ahead and I'd like to kind of separate out these cables, the ones that we're going to need. Here's our CPU connector. We're going to go ahead and route that one as well. Then we also have our data our power connector for our SATA drive, SSD here. And what we're going to do is we're just going to connect this. It's a L-blade shaped connector. That connects the power on this side. But then we also have to run a data cable. So here's our serial ATA data cable. And again, this is a blade-shaped L-blade connector. And it just snaps into place there. So now we've got pretty much that cable ready to go. What I'm going to do is there is a little routing hole right here by the motherboard. I'm actually going to just feed that through right there. And let me try to get this around our motherboard, and we'll feed that through. That'll be one of the very first ones that we actually route through. Now, we do have a series of other cables that we want to go ahead and get routed through. So we're going to take our front panel headers and some of these other cables, and what we will do here is just kind of pull them through as well. And just be mindful of their position. This is our USB 3.0 connector, and we're going to go ahead and run that through likewise. And again, we're just kind of feeding these through. And then we got our front panel connector. This is actually the hard drive LED light, so we're going to go ahead and feed that through likewise. And then we've got our audio connection. This is our HD audio connector. We're going to go ahead and we'll feed that through. Now we've got just a couple more that we've got to kind of take care of here. We've got our, this is a SATA connector, and this SATA connector is actually for the LED lights. And one of the great things is in some of these power supplies, we don't really have to feed this one through. We can just go ahead, make sure that the L blade is lined up appropriately, and we can just push and clip that in place, and that one's actually ready to go. Now, we do have some other ones that we need to route appropriately. Here is our 20 plus 4 pin connector, and this is going to go more towards the top of our case right here, and that's because the main power connector is in that location. And we're going to go ahead and just kind of feed that one through. And we'll come back and do, once we know that we've got our cables in the right position, we'll have an episode on our cable management portion. Now, we've got a couple of other connectors that we want to make sure that we are making a good connection. That we are routing, this is the PCIe. You gotta be careful too with your main CPU connectors and your PCI connectors because these look identical. The good thing is they're marked on it. This one says CPU, this one says PCIe. So we don't want to use that one for, even though they look really, really close, like they're the same type of connector, you want to be sure that you have the right one. A lot of your power supplies today will have these clearly marked like this one does, and again, saying CPU right on that little clip. And we're just going to take that, and again, I'm just routing these through right here, the routing positions that we have, the little route holes. cutouts. And now what we have to do is, for now, I'm going to take these other connectors that we're not using, and we're just going to kind of bundle them back up the way they were, and I'm just going to, for now, roll them back into kind of a little ball here, and then I'm going to just put this Velcro on it. Now, these aren't in a finished state. Please don't think that I'm going to leave the cabling in this kind of condition. What we're trying to do is just establish the fact that we've got our cables kind of where we want. I loose lay them first, and then we come back and we do the cable management, and that's more of the beautification side, if you will. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to flip this case over, and then when we come back, we're going to show you how to make all of those connections to your motherboard. Well, we flipped the case over, and now it's time to make our connections. And what we're gonna do here is we're actually gonna start at the top of the motherboard in relation to the case, and we're just gonna kinda go in an L pattern here, connecting all the connectors. One of the first ones that we're gonna do is this 8-pin CPU connector. And I can tell you right now, this thing can be a little bit of a bear to get in here, so I'm gonna kinda struggle with it for a second here, and then hopefully we can get this in there fairly decent. There's one of them. Sometimes it can be a pain depending on how tight the cables are, because the cables coming off of the power supply, they can be pretty tight sometime, and sometimes they can give you a little bit of a hard time just trying to move them. So we'll just try to get that connector in there, and again, try not to put too much force down there. You definitely want to get a good tight connection. So if we take a look here, you can see we've actually got that connected. That is our 8-pin power connector. Now, kind of moving down the line here, the next one I want to connect is our CPU fan here. You could probably see that it says fan and a U. That's actually the CPU fan. And earlier when we attached our heatsink, I said that I would save this and we would come back and we would show you how to connect that. Now, this one's pretty straightforward. It is just a simple connection on the motherboard, and it does have a locking connector like a lot of these do, so you should be able to line it up fairly easy. And there we go, that one is connected. I tied that knot in it, kind of help with some of the cable management. Now, if we walk on down the line, one of the things you'll see here is that we have our 24-pin connector, and this is a good power supply in the fact that it really supports going way back to the original ATX standard, a 20-pin connector. And what you can do is you can put both of those, the 4-pin P4 connector and then the 20-pin connector, into a solid connector here. And then this is another one that sometimes can give you a hard time getting these lined up and in there. But for the most part, this case is giving us a lot of room to work with, which is really nice. And there we go. That seems to be connected. We have our power connector. It is now firmly seated, and we are good. If we move down the line, the next one that we're going to go ahead and connect, and that's going to be our USB connector here. And this one has one of the pins is actually missing. It's a solid plate, if you will, and that actually lines up with the other side of this connector. And it is also a locking connector. So I'm just going to go ahead and plug that in. Now, I will tell you, the other one that we have right here is a system fan, but we're actually going to have an episode on attaching our system fans, because I want to attach our system fan that came with the case, and I also want to go ahead and attach a couple of fans on the front side of the case, and I want to show you how to do that. So we're going to leave that for a little bit later. The next one is going to be our data connector. We want to get our data connector, that's to our serial ATA drive, our solid state drive, and that's actually going to connect right down here. And we're going to use the 45 degree angle here, and let me kind of tuck this back a little bit easier, and we're just going to go ahead and we will plug it right in. And you'll hear that audible click. That's what we want. We're good to go on that. Now, if we move down the line, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to connect our power switch. All right, our power switch actually comes off the front panel up here, and that's where we turn our power on. Now, pay attention to the motherboard and your case and verify that you have the proper arrangement. For me, the power connector actually gets placed in this position here. That's not always going to be the case on every motherboard that you do. So again, just pay attention to whatever the specifications. The next one is the hard drive. And in this case, we got a solid state drive, but drive light LED. So we know when the drive is actually moving. That is actually going to be in this position right here. So we'll go ahead and we'll connect that up. And again, I would say just pay attention to the fact that depending on how your motherboard is arranged, you want, or what the vendor says will dictate how these actually get lined up here. Now, moving down the line here, the next one that we have is actually our LEDs for this case. This case comes with some interesting LED lights, which may or may not be your thing. Hey, I figure, why not? Originally, I was kind of skeptical on whether I was going to actually use something like this. But hey, it came with the case, so we're going to go ahead and we will plug this in, and it's just a 4-pin connection right there. There we go. Connect it up. We're ready to go. Again, moving kind of down the line here, one of the last ones that we're going to connect, this one is all the way over on the other side of the street here. This is your high-definition audio connector, and you'll see this actually has a pin that's missing as well, and that actually lines up down there to the pin that's missing inside of that connector. Now, I know my hand, maybe even a little bit of my head will get in the way. Apologize ahead of time. But you got to kind of see what you're doing here. And let me go ahead and I will just click that in place, and you can kind of feel it go right in, and it's perfect. It fits just fine. We are good. And these essentially are our connectors. In this episode, we looked at the main power connectors, the CPU power connector. We've seen the USB 3.0 audio, the front, the audio as well, and as the front panels, the hard drive light indicator, as well as the power button. So there you go. We've made our connections, and that's how you do it when you build your PC.
Thank you for watching IT Pro TV.